to fill from Chief Rosh, but Chief Rosh filled big shoes from Chief Hetznecker. But more importantly, I'm here to recognize the village president, Dave Lamerand, and I've been, like I said, 16 years here. I know what pure community service is, and you represent pure community service, Dave. And 28 years, I believe.
26 as village president, or as trustee for a total of 30.
30. I cut the difference.
Yes.
So you always started the meetings on time. You ran a tight ship here. And believe me, going around to 16 communities, you really did a fine job. And as I said earlier, pure community service, and you gave your heart and soul to the village of Hartland, and you should be applauded for that. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Okay, seeing as there are no other parties, we'll move on to consideration of a motion to approve the village board minutes of the March 27th meeting.
Also moved.
It's been moved and seconded to approve the minutes as submitted. Discussion.
Okay, a couple of things I note we need to correct. One is the criticism related to the chimney sweeps, or the bird oven. The $87,000 does not indicate the $11,000, that $11,000+ that we lost on that transaction. I'd like that notes to reflect that. I mean, it's an asset, but an asset, just we still lost $11,600+. So that's one thing. The other thing is when we were discussing, we're talking about related actions with regard to a slight increase in wages and compensation. I was talking about the police department, and it wasn't with regard to any other of the workman's comp for any of the other people or the fire personnel. It was strictly police. So those two things I think need to be corrected. Thank you.
We need a motion.
I'll entertain a motion to make the corrections.
I'll move to make the corrections.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded to revise the village board minutes of the March 27th meeting. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion is carried. And now we'll have I'll entertain a motion to approve the village board minutes as amended.
Also moved.
Second.
Been moved and seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion is carried. Next item is consideration of a motion to approve the vouchers for payment in the amount of $458,120.21.
I move we pay the bills for $458,120.21.
Second.
Been moved and seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed?
Abstain.
Motion is carried. Next item is consideration of actions related to licenses and permits, and we have consideration of applications for operators' bartender licenses with a term ending June 30th, 2018 for Teresa Buskey, the police chief and village clerk, recommend approval.
Also moved.
Second.
Been moved and seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion is carried. The next item is consideration of a motion to approve an agreement between the Village of Hartland and Patrick Entner to operate a beer garden in Nixon Park from June 8th through August 20th, 2017.
As I, as the board will recall, and certainly there was a discussion about the Village Park Board, and the Village Board have agreed to a concept that would have a beer garden in Nixon Park for the summer, 4 days a week. This is now the follow-up to that. This is the actual agreement between the parties to enable that to occur. Talks about the term, which is a finite amount of time for this, basically this season. It talks about the hours. That's where there is one change that's between the time that the plan, or rather the park board saw it and the village board saw it, and that relates to staying open late when there's an event in the park. It relates to the fee, which is 6% of his gross sales, location, et cetera, et cetera. Insurance requirements. Mr. Enter is required to insure the activity. Very similar, or at least it started initially to look similar to our concession stand agreement that we had with him, but there's more to this particular project, so there's a little bit more in the agreement. Basically, Pat's going to take it on, and as a license fee, we'll pay us.
I have a quick question.
Mm-hmm.
And not to overstep anything, but I've noticed in here, like, if there's any modifications to the concession stand or where the beer goes or lighting and that, wouldn't that need to go back through the architecture planning committee instead of going through you, Dave? I mean, that's a lot of extra work for you.
Well, the beer will be stored inside, so that wouldn't normally go anywhere.
Well, it just says a storage of the beer may be allowed in a cooler provided by them in a location approved by you.
Right, and that is they're not making any architectural changes mm-hmm. to the building, so it would not go before the plan commission or the architectural board.
What about the modifications and improvements to the interior of the concession stand?
That's on the interior. Again, architectural board would not look at that. Okay, the interior we do not review.
That came through the park board who shared
right.
that day.
And that would be a park board issue. Because they basically are the owners of that facility.
Well, I'm just saying, because on here it says that
me.
Yeah.
Yes.
And so frankly, what that's intended to do is allow that the final decisions that get made by staff. I don't do any of that in a vacuum.
Okay.
Get made by staff. And as some of the trustees are alluding to, Trustee Landwehr in particular, we talked about some of this stuff at the park board
mm-hmm.
and the generalities of it were okay. For example, with respect to the beer cooler, when we were at the park board, if I remember correctly, we talked about basically three potential locations for that.
Mm-hmm.
The warming shed, backstage area basically inside the center
mm-hmm.
and in one of the storage rooms. Frankly, the first and last things I mentioned really don't work well, so it likely will end up in the backstage area of the concession or of the stage
mm-hmm.
and you know, clearly, as you can tell by my voice, not my favorite, but that's where it'll end up.
Well, it just simply seemed like a lot was being put on your shoulders that
being there is that it's a staff person rather than having to come back through
okay,
the process
okay.
Frankly, I think Mike and the DPW will make the final
okay.
choices on
okay.
the concession
okay.
stand.
See, the other reason was, if it came back to the park board, which has to go first, and then we have to wait a month, if something came up, he'd have to wait a month or we'd have to call
right.
a special meeting.
Right.
So the park board discussed the fact that it should go back to the Dave so that they wouldn't have to go through this whole rigmarole again.
Well, that makes sense.
That,
I just thought it was extra work.
Plus,
for the
extra work, he would have had to have done that work to begin with if it comes to the architectural board.
Yeah.
Oh.
Staff has to review the plans when it gets submitted to us, so you're not saving him any work.
That'd be at his expense, right?
Yes.
Not ours.
Yeah. Yes.
I hope you mean Pat.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Now, the question with this agreement, it doesn't say anything about people carrying in. And I always wonder how many officers Mike's going to assign to every night that the beer is being sold there just to police that situation, or what are we going to do? I mean, you talk about the 4th of July and you talk about the other things. There might be one or two beverages in there.
There will be one or two beverages
yep.
in there. Pat has, Mr. Enter has said a number of occasions that carry-in is fine. From his perspective, obviously he would prefer they acquire it from him. But
it's not fine with us, because it's against
we do not allow that in the park. Do we?
You can get, you can carry in.
Yeah.
You can carry into the park.
Yeah.
People were carrying in the Thursday night concerts.
So it's okay, we can drink in the parks.
Well.
You already do.
But not out of a brown paper bag.
Well, it doesn't hold liquid. All right, so that's not gonna be a problem.
No.
Because they even bring it in the ballgame, baseball games and everything else when they sell it. You got, unless you get a policeman out there guard, watching everybody.
All right, thank you.
There's no other questions, I'll entertain a motion.
Also moved.
Second.
They moved and seconded to approve the agreement between the Village of Hartland and Patrick Entner to operate the beer garden in Nixon Park. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion is carried. Thank you, Patrick.
Thank you.
Next item is a presentation by representatives of the Hartland Night Out and consideration of actions related to approval of the event.
Good evening. My name is Kelly Yogers. I'm the recreation director, and I'm here with Elise and Anna, who are the main organizers of the Hartland Neighborhood Night Out, the downtown portion of it. My portion is the movie in the park, and I will let them talk about the downtown part first.
So from 5 to 8:30, we are asking businesses in downtown in the bid to have an open doors event, and we'll have flyers to go out to participants that are coming around and walking to different businesses, and they're providing different activities, food, tasting. This will be our fourth year doing it.
Okay.
And then in addition to that, we are looking to have a wagon pulled by a tractor to shuttle throughout the downtown area. Route and stop to be determined, which I know I guess is a little more of an issue than we thought it was going to be, so that's most of our approval. Anything else?
No, that's pretty much it. I mean, it's pretty similar to the rest of the years or past years that we've done it, except for the wagon part.
And then in the park, we will have the concerts from 7 to 9, and then we'll have a movie starting at 9, and I think we're going to have it by the beer garden. And that's pretty much it for the event. Any questions?
Seeing it as art, and I'll entertain a motion.
I move to approve.
Second.
They moved and seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed? Motion is carried. Thank you.
Good luck, Alice.
The next item is staff updated related to the parking on Pauling Avenue at Prospect Avenue in consideration of a motion to approve the proposed plan. Mike?
Good evening. 2 weeks ago, staff brought before the Village Board a consideration of some parking restrictions along Pauling Avenue due to some concerns that were raised by the residents and businesses out there. The Village Board approved the no parking on the north side in front of 248 Pauling. That has been already signed, and that no parking zone is in effect. Staff worked with the Village Engineer's office to prepare a parking plan where we'd have diagonal on-street parking both in front of the building and to the east between the building and the two municipal lots down near Cottonwood Avenue. That plan is attached in your staff report along with a cost estimate. We can add this as an addendum to the 2017 paving program, get bids on that, and construct that later on this year.
Mike, are you gonna, when I looked at that 18 parking spaces, you go down to the parking lot that's there now, down to where Ordway's is when I look at that?
We're a little bit shy of that. There's a little bit area, but right where the park, where the sidewalk makes a little jog to adjacent to the road from a part, that's how far we've gone down with the parking spaces.
So then when you put the angle parking in front of the building and you cut that part of the street out, are we going all widening that street all the way down or just to the parking lot?
We'll be replacing the existing barrier curb with a valley gutter curb, and then from that valley gutter curb we'll be taking the parking area up towards the adjacent sidewalk by the building, and then we'll have a barrier curb between the sidewalk and the parking area.
2 weeks ago, didn't they say that they were going to get the bids for us?
They said they would assist us, but because of the size of the project, we would have to competitively bid this project.
How soon will that be done? Will it be done by fall?
Yes, as part of this year's paving. I don't know exactly when we would fit it in, but we'd work with the, whatever contractor gets the award to see how soon we can get that parking area in.
You can tell those people that are interested in that how long they're going to be.
Right, we're anticipating probably about 4 weeks for the construction.
Mike, where are the customers that would come there or people that would have an appointment, where are they parking right now?
All over the place.
Right now, everybody is parking along the curb in front of the building.
Okay.
I was there this morning at about 8:30. There's about four cars parked there. And then this afternoon, there was probably about eight cars parked along that curb line.
How much room is there in front of there down to that first parking lot? Enough from, what, 10, 12 cars?
Probably about 10 cars, okay. Yes.
I would think that we should push it up in the schedule to the front of the schedule for paving, and that when we get our bids back and start construction.
Well, we put out the addendum tomorrow so we could put in there that we would like it done probably by earlier to mid-June.
Or if they got a way of starting that first and then follow up with the rest. So those people aren't put into that bad spot, the whole neighborhood there, you know.
Right. Understood.
Because I looked at it, I think that would be perfect when you get angle parking in that shit. So
The paving can come almost any time, but
well, you got to see, you got to cut that out.
But no, I mean the
oh yeah,
regular paving out, repair yeah. stuff can, but this is more of a
emergency
problem.
We can do that. We can have that scheduled for the first part of the contract.
Good.
Good.
I'll entertain a motion.
Also move.
Second.
Excuse me. Second.
What are we approving?
We're approving the
adding Pauling it to the
Avenue. We're okay. Approving the Pauling Avenue proposed parking lot improvement to be included in this year's capital project expenditures. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion is carried. The next item is consideration of a motion to approve an award of a contract to Wood Sewer and Excavating for the 2017 utility project in the amount of $449,348.
In advance of the paving that's going on in Bristlecone Pine subdivision, we would like to repair the utilities. We have storm sewer improvements, sanitary sewer improvements, and water utility improvements. We had five bidders. Wood Sewer and Excavating has not worked for the village, but we've done reference checks, and they like to specialize in these smaller projects as opposed to larger full-length water main replacements. So based on the references, we are recommending that Wood be awarded the contract. Just a few things. Originally, when we budgeted this work, unfortunately, the storm sewer improvements that we found out there were a little more extensive. And for the water main work, initially, we weren't going to be replacing the fire hydrants. Well, with the fire hydrants so close to the edge of the road, if we would delay that, we could cause more damage to the road in the future replacing those fire hydrants than doing it all right now as part of the valve replacement. So we did find some unallocated funds in the CIP to cover the stormwater by delaying the design work at the Nixon Park Pond for the dredging work. And we did find some available fund balance in the water utility to add in the hydrants. So that's why we're looking for the higher award.
That only makes sense.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, we'll entertain a motion.
Also move the approval of Wood Sewer and Excavating Inc.
Second.
Been moved and seconded to approve the award of the contract to Wood Sewer and Excavating in the amount of $449,348. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion is carried.
Thank you.
Well, will that be done before fall, too? I mean,
yes.
Temporarily. Yeah, okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay, next item is consideration of resolution 410-2017-01, a resolution designating public depositories and authorizing withdrawal of village monies.
Good evening, Ryan Bailey, the finance director. As the resolution kind of states, what we would like to do is open up a possible relationship with Westbury Bank. We have the opportunity for relationships with all the banks in the village of Hartland except Westbury. They're relatively new. I had a meeting with Kathy from Westbury a couple weeks ago. They offer a very, very competitive interest rate that is secured and backed by securities. Most times, if you take a CD, up to $250,000 is insured by the federal government. Anything over that is uninsured. So we've gotten into programs such as CDARS where they kind of split off the CDs to different states that are all kind of connected through the same bank. What Westbury does is they physically take it and they take securities to back any amount over $250,000. So it would show up on the financial statement as uninsured but collateralized. And that is currently how our money market is with First Bank.
What type of securities do they collateralize?
Whatever they have. It's generally your it's got to be AAA rated, and it's going to be generally bonds, that type of investments. And they can have anywhere from 0 to 30 years until maturity, but if something would happen with our funds, you would sell them off and get the money you can get. Anytime they collateralize, it has to be at 102% by state statute. So if we invested $1 million, they would put an extra 2%.
And maybe if you explain a little bit like you did, it's not a walk-in bank. I mean, it
correct.
Is. It's not a walk-in bank for people.
Not the Hartland location. The Hartland location has, on the second story, it's more of a commercial side of things. We could do our everyday banking there. We're not currently choosing to do that. We would just like to get a initial relationship started at some point if the investment rate is still high. So, and if we approve it, I will contact her to see where we are at for rates.
I have a quick question.
Sure.
How do you decide it says that the board is authorizing you transfer up to $1 million?
Mm-hmm.
How do you decide, or when do you decide how much you're going to do, or?
I'm going to talk. I told her we'd start some sort of relationship. I've spoke to Dave a couple times in regards to this. In May, we have our CDARS, which is where we have $3.5 million with First Bank, is coming due. So that $3.5 million, what I would probably do in May, is see what the rates are at Westbury. And the reason I say allow me to go to Westbury, mm-hmm. if First Bank has a better rate or Town Bank or somebody has a better rate, I may not go to Westbury, but I'd like to be able to have that relationship with them.
Okay.
For the village.
I hate to ask, but what is a going rate these days for a short-term money?
You can get a two-year CD for about 1.4. That's why they're very competitive. Our 18-month with Equitable Bank, which is in Delafield, is at 1.1%. So that was relatively decent. But even our regular money market, we're at about 0.65.
So, 0.65.
Yeah. It's quadrupled in last year, so, it's okay. Nice, but there's only so much that we can do. There's certain things that the state restricts us to as far as what we can invest in.
It's probably good, but it's just depressing a little.
But I'd like to try and get $1 million somewhere else at a higher rate. So,
do we have to make any kind of investment with them?
Nope. No, with them we would just start a relationship. We can just put money in a CD, and that's it. So,
I'll entertain a motion on resolution 410-2017-01.
Also move.
I'll second.
We moved and seconded to adopt resolution 410-2017-01, a resolution designating public depositories and authorizing withdrawal of village monies. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion is carried. Then we have a consideration of a motion to authorize staff to transfer up to $1 million to Westbury Bank for investment purposes.
Also moved.
Second.
Been moved and seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion is carried.
All right, thank you. If we do go forward with it, I'll put that in the info pack or staff update at that time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Ryan. Next item, our announcements. I have one. I want to thank the residents for the opportunity. It was a privilege and an honor that you have bestowed upon me to represent this village as an elected official. The village has changed greatly in the last 30 years. We've had our ups and downs with the economy, but at this point in time, I believe that the village is being left in extremely solid financial position with the developments that have been taking place last year and this year. It should help make the budgeting process easier and keep taxes down. It's again, when I look around at the things that have happened, the Fine Arts Center, the library, the additional Bristol Cone Pines River Reserve, the Bark River Commerce Center, a lot of these items were not just ordinary, yeah, okay, let's do them. Some of them were struggles. And I don't think that we have made too many mistakes as a village board during that 30 years that I've been in, been involved. We have great people on this board with lots of years of experience. We're bringing somebody on new, and I think that Dave Cox and myself have met with Mr. Pfannerstill, and I think we had some very productive discussions of where we stand in the village and what's coming up for the future. I just want to again take the opportunity to thank the people for giving me the opportunity to serve this community. Thank you very much. Next item.
I want to say something too, Dave. I want to thank you for the time and every effort you put in there and the years that I've served with you. And just thank you.
Thank you. Okay, next item is consideration of motion to recess to close session pursuant to State Statutes 19.85, paragraph 1, sub e, deliberating or negotiating the purchasing of public properties, the investing of public funds, or conducting other specified public business whenever competitive or bargaining reasons require a closed session regarding downtown development.
I'd like to make a motion to go into closed session.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded. May I have a roll call, please?
Trustee Stevens?
Aye.
Trustee Myers?
Aye.
Trustee Compton?
Aye.
Trustee Landwehr?
Aye.
Trustee Swenson?
Aye.
Trustee Walshlager?
Aye.
President Lamerand?
Aye. We are. We will recess into closed session, but we will reconvene into open session, but not taking action other than what has already taken place. The reason for convening is that this is a lame duck board and we need to approve the minutes of tonight's meeting, and that's all it will be. So I want to thank everybody for tuning in tonight and attending the meeting, and thank you very much.